Ladies and gentlemen, guys, can you see my screen now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Let me turn off my camera first because I have a bad connection. Usually, I turn on my camera. Yeah. Okay. Let's go on discussing about order letter, a kind of letter. This is a very important kind of letter in business letter. All right. Yeah, order means that someone's or a company who sends this letter, it will become an expense. Yeah. So expense means that if we order some goods or some sums for other companies, of course, yeah, of course, 100% we should pay, yeah, the charge. We should pay the charge of the goods, and then also maybe about the carriage, yeah, pengirimannya itu membutuhkan biaya. It needs money, of course, selain harga barangnya. Okay, a lot of commitments to ensure that it has a satisfied customer, which can be an individual or another company. Timely delivery of the order, quality of delivery, and after-sale service are all part and parcel of getting order. Means that in both companies, the recipient and also the sender, they have commitments, yeah, both each other, yeah. Okay, the buyer has to ensure about the how they receive the good, yeah, and how much money they should pay. So it will become about the goods, the price, and also the quantity, the qualities. So it means commitments, especially for the carriage, yeah. Is it transported by a plane? Is it using train or van, menggunakan mobil kah, pesawat kah, or kereta kah, etc. Ya, jadi itu termasuk harus diketahui oleh kedua belah pihak before sending the order letter. Ya, karena untuk di surat order ini, pembelian ini, it has to be specific. Ya. It doesn't have long sentences, ya, karena nanti contentsnya atau body of paragraphnya itu langsung jenis barang yang dipesan. So that's called order letter. Jadi banyak komitmen atau perjanjian yang harus ditepati oleh kedua belah pihak, ya. Including katanya termasuk apakah ada diskon, oke? Apakah di situ ada hadiah atau compliments, ya, yang didapatkan oleh si pembeli after sending the goods atau sekalian dengan barangnya, biasanya seperti itu, ya. It will persuade or it will entertain the buyer kalau kita penjual memberikan compliments or hadiah-hadiah tambahan. Alright, so written by the person. So who write the order letter? Usually the writer should be the person who is the person in charge in taking or in placing the order. Jadi orang yang khusus untuk menuliskan atau menandatangani surat order, surat pembelian barang itu, berarti yang lebih dominan itu purchasing department, ya. Purchasing department itu berarti yang mengeluarkan suratnya, and then who signs it, yang menandatangani, maybe the manager of the purchasing, ya, lebih spesifik dia langsung berhubungan dengan pembelian atau penjualan, ya. Okay, this letter comes into action only when a detailed study of desired product has been done in the market and based on promised service, quality, and price of the product, a decision for a purchase has been made. So before we send our order letter, we have to make sure that we have listed all the goods that we have to buy. And then how about the quantity? So sebelum kita menuliskan semuanya itu di surat pembelian barang, kita memang sudah harus mengetahui bagaimana kriteria barang tersebut, jenisnya tersedia atau tidak. Makanya before we send order letter, we need inquiries, information about the products. Makanya kita tidak asal-asalkan memesan. Barang yang memang sudah tersedia aja, available, baru kita pesan, ya. Jadi tidak sia-sia kita mengirimkan surat pesanan, ya. So, guys, ini juga harus lebih diutamakan. Berapa? Karena memang kita lebih spesifik ketika membayar pasti bagaimana quantity-nya, jumlahnya berapa. Kualitasnya, is it a new or a second one? Ya, biasanya kalau barang yang mau dijual lagi oleh supplier, pasti akan membeli barang baru, not the second one. Okay? A decision for a purchase has been made. Ya, kita harus memutuskan surat pembelian kita ini sehubungan dengan inquiry atau dari katalog-katalog yang sudah kita terima. Karena katalog tersebut berisi informasi specifically about the goods. Okay. Should be drafted very carefully as it needs to pen down all the terms and condition of the purchase for the benefits of both involved parties. Jadi kedua belah pihak memang harus saling menguntungkan dengan adanya terms and conditions. Ada di sini pra dan syarat, ya, prasyarat. Ya, hal-hal yang harus kita pembeli harus tunduk kepada aturan-aturan penjual. Penjual juga menerima saran atau apa ya, complaints dari si customer atau si pembeli. Ya, jadi memang harus dibuatkan surat itu sebelum ditulis ada draftnya. Ya, jadi tidak asal-asalan. Kesalahan kecil akan berpengaruh kepada apa ya namanya, nama baik si perusahaan, khususnya perusahaan yang ingin memesan barang. Okay, it should have details such as product specifications, quantities, price agreed upon, delivery date, late delivery clauses, etc. Okay, di sini harus kita jelaskan tanggal berapa sih deadline barang tersebut kita harus terima. Because perusahaan kita misalkan juga penyedia barang untuk warung-warung kecil, kita perlu butuh barang itu sesuai yang kita janjikan pada customer kita juga. So, we have to put that delivery date, late delivery. For example, we promise or we put the date, kami harus menerima, we must or we have to receive the goods not more than, ini tanggal berapa, 30, not more than 1st of November. Kalau kamu terima tanggal 2, berarti you have a right to reject the order, ya. Yeah? Jadi kita sebagai pembeli juga harus memang di sini harus tegas, ya. Ini adalah surat bisnis yang berhubungan dengan uang millions or billions rupiahs or dollars. Ya, we have to put specific date, delivery date, ya. And it should be addressed to the person responsible for the execution of the order with a copy to the head of department. Since it is totally an official letter, it should be typed. Ya, kita harus nanti di sini harus langsung dirujuk surat itu spesifik ke siapa. Jadi harus disebutkan namanya. Even though it is a department, di departemen itu siapa yang lebih bertanggung jawab terhadap apa namanya surat pembelian kita. Gitu ya. Nah, jadi since it is totally official, karena ini surat resmi, you have to type it. Ya, not in handwriting. Ladies and gentlemen, because sometimes if you have a good handwriting, it doesn't mean other people can read your handwriting. Meskipun menurut kita atau teman kita tulisan tangan kita memang bagus, tapi mungkin orang lain tidak bisa apa namanya? It is not clearly to differ between huruf D dan B atau A dan D, ya. Yeah? So, we have to type it. Okay, do's and don'ts, artinya apa sih yang harus dilakukan dan jangan dan tidak boleh dilakukan in making order letter. The first one, an order letter should be addressed to the person responsible for executing the order. As I told you just now, the specific person who is the person in charge who takes the action of our order letter. Siapa yang langsung mengeksekusi surat pesanan kita. Yeah. It should be include all the terms and condition agreed upon by both involved parties. Nah, ini berhubungan dengan terms and condition, artinya syarat-syarat, contohnya pembelian itu, apa namanya, pengiriman itu melalui transportasi apa, and then syarat-syaratnya seperti apa, apakah pembayaran uang keseluruhan barang 50% in advance payment, atau nanti langsung dibayarkan setelah barang sampai di tujuan, atau mungkin dikasih tanggal ya, misalkan 15 hari setelah barang diterima di perusahaan kami. Jadi ada memang khusus terms and condition, dan sebelumnya memang kedua belah pihak harus sudah saling memberitahu. Ya, okay. Since it is purely an official letter, it should be typed. I told you just now, we have to type this letter because this is a very official. There is no need to use too many adjectives in the letter since it is purely for an order being placed. Means that we have to straightforward. Means that jangan bertele-tele. Makanya di kata di kalimat-kalimat yang kita tuliskan pasti lebih banyak kata kerja karena we need an action. Yeah. Okay. The letter should have all relevant details related to the order. For example, quantity, price, and other terms and conditions. Ini semua adalah apa namanya recap dari empat halaman yang saya sudah jelaskan di sebelumnya ya. Jadi those do's and don'ts, artinya hal yang harus dan tidak boleh dilakukan di dalam membuat surat lamaran. Okay, this is an example of an order letter sent by Colorwood. This is the name of the company and this is the address. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, because maybe I'm asking you later on your mid test about the parts of this letter. Yeah, this is the head of the letter and this is the date. This is the inside address. Okay, this is the subject line. Okay, okay, we can shorten using sub in subject. Yeah, dear sirs, salutation. Okay, yeah, let's go on to read this letter. Melinda, could you please help me to read this from a salutation until the closing? Melinda, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, I need your help to read this, please. And try as best as you can. Dibaca saja dari sini sampai akhir.
Dari mana, sir?
Can you see it clearly?
Ya, yeah, dari mana, sir, bacanya?
Dari dear sir, dari salutation.
Oh. Dear sir, thank you for your question and the price list. We are glad to place our first order with you for the following items.
Okay, let me read this and then you continue this. Okay, these items, the first one is name of paint, the quantity 25 tins, okay, specific weight 100, okay, albis, I don't know, unit price 1,000, amount 25,000. Maybe this is $1. The second product is synthetic paint. We need 20 tins and the weight 200 albis and the unit price for this is 2,000 and the amount is 40,000. And the last goods that we have to place is white paint, as much as many as 10 tins, and the weight is 10 lbs, and the unit price is 500, and the amount 500 until 70,000. So you go on for the sentences. Silakan dilanjut, Neng. Ayo, biar
since,
kelasnya aktif. Yo.
Since the above goods are required, apa itu?
Immediately,
as our stock is about to exhaust very soon, we request you to send the goods through your motor van as the carriage inward is supposed to be.
Baca aja sesuka kamu, yang penting apa yang
ya. Tulisannya nggak kelihatan, Miss. Sir.
Okay. Let me make it bigger. Sorry. Okay. I mean, this is I copied this letter from the internet. Okay.
We shall arrange by payment within the 10 days to complete with 5 or 10. Not 30 terms. Please send all commercial and financial documents along with goods. We reserve the right to reject the goods if received late. Yours faithfully, Muhammad Tarek, Purchase Manager, Color World.
Thank you so much, Melinda, for helping me. It's been helpful. Yeah, terima kasih. Yeah, as I told you just now, this is a kind of order letter, specific sentences, guys. Jadi tidak bertele-tele. Yeah, dear sir. Yeah, dengan hormat. Terima kasih atas informasi dan barang yang Anda jual dan juga berikut dengan daftar harganya. Kami sangat senang untuk membeli put the place first, artinya kami melakukan pembelian pertama kami terhadap perusahaan Anda dengan nama barang-barang di bawah ini. Jadi ada 3 tipe chat di sini, chat ya. Mereka membeli enable paint, synthetic paint, white paint ya. Di sini jelas quantity ya, jumlahnya 25 kaleng, 20 kaleng. Mungkin beratnya berbeda-beda, tapi mereka meminta berat yang 100 lbs, bisa kita bilang yang liter lah ya, 100 liter, 200 liter, 10 liter. Unit price-nya ini, unit price namanya unit berarti per, berarti ya. Karena ini 1000 per unit, berarti karena 25 unit berarti jadi 25.000. Seperti itu ya. Oke, jadi totalnya semuanya sebenarnya ini 70 ya totalnya. Is it? Yes. 40 added by 25, 65 added by 5, and then 60 ya. So the last amount here, that's the total guys. Ya, karena barang tersebut kami butuhkan, sangat kami butuhkan katanya immediately, karena stok barang yang kami punya sudah sangat sedikit, exhaust, artinya sudah hampir habis. Kami meminta Anda mengirimkan barang atau pesanan kami melalui mobil van perusahaan Anda karena biaya pengiriman semestinya ditanggung oleh Anda, perusahaan Anda. Ya, kami akan melakukan pembayaran 10 hari dan pembayaran akan kami lengkapi tertanggal 5 bulan 10. Ya. Silakan lampirkan atau silakan dikirimkan juga mungkin katalog komersial, itu berarti yang berhubungan dengan katalog ya. Katalog atau special price ya. Itu namanya komersial dan dokumen-dokumen pembayaran dengan barang tersebut. Artinya barang dan dokumen-dokumen pendukung harus sudah langsung diterima oleh si pembeli. Oke, kami berhak untuk tidak menerima barang tersebut jika dikirimkan terlambat. Oke, ladies and gentlemen. Nah, di sini harus dijelaskan lebih spesifik tadi. Ya, we reserve the right to reject the goods if received late. Oke, nah ini balasan dari surat tersebut. Oke, I need... Who's on this? I need Fadlan, please, to read this letter. Fadlan, could you please help me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, I need your help to read this.
Dear sir,
come on.
Dear sir, we thanks you for your order. Pay 3/7 September 1, 2012 for various paints. The order is in process of execution and it will be dispatched on 8 September by our motor van. We have taken special care for quality and packing of the paint, and we hope that you will find them highly satisfactory. We thank you again for your kind offer of the paint and hope that you will extend your similar cooperation in future. With best regards, your faithfully.
All right, thank you Adlan for helping me. Yeah, yes, jadi sir. Ini when we are the seller, we receive the order letter and then we have to reply, means that we have to confirm that we have received the letter from the other company or our supplier or our client, yeah. Okay, this is subject line, means that perihal surat konfirmasi atas konfirmasi atas surat tertanggal satu. Ya, suratnya tadi benar tanggal 1, jadi harus kita pastikan. And then is this? Okay, sorry. Okay, benar ya, 1 September. Di sini ya jelas ya. Dan benar enggak nomor ordernya seperti itu? Oke, nomor ordernya memang dari si penjual ya. Oke, nomor ordernya, we thank you for your order number P37, dated tanggal 1 bulan September 2012 terhadap, atas beberapa macam cat ya. The order is in process ya, order tersebut sedang kami proses dan akan dikirimkan tertanggal 8 September ya, melalui atau dengan menggunakan mobil van perusahaan kami. We have taken special care of the quality and packing them and packing of the paints. Artinya kami sangat berhati-hati terhadap kualitas barang yang kami kirimkan dan telah membungkus ya, packing ya, dan membungkus cat tersebut dengan sangat baik. Dan kami berharap perusahaan Anda menerima barang tersebut dengan tanpa cacat, highly satisfactory. We thank you again, terima kasih kembali atas kesediaan Anda membeli cat dari perusahaan kami, dan kami berharap perusahaan Anda akan terus bekerja sama dengan perusahaan kami ke depannya. Alright, we thank you again for a kind offer of the paints and hope that you will extend your similar cooperation in the future. Kita harus memberikan kata-kata persuasif seperti ini, ya, biar customer-nya atau klien kita berpikir positif tentang perusahaan kita. Maksudnya memang kita sangat berharap klien-klien seperti mereka, gitu ya. Apa yang kalian harus dapatkan di surat ini? Nah, yang pertama, ketika when you received an order letter and then you are the person in charge to reply the letter, kamu harus tahu tanggal surat yang kamu terima tanggal berapa. Karena banyak memang kalau salah tanggal nanti siapa tahu perusahaan ini mengirimkan surat sebelum tanggal ini. Ya kan, bisa saja mereka tanggal 30 Agustus mengirimkan surat. Jadi surat yang mana? Gitu ya, harus jelas di sini. Dan kamu sebutkan nomor ordernya karena nanti si pembeli akan melihat apa namanya ya, dokumennya itu benar nggak ya? Surat, benar nggak sih suratnya ini sesuai dengan nomor ini? Gitu ya. Oke. Khususnya perusahaan yang mungkin dalam seminggu mengirimkan surat kepada kita berkali-kali. Jadi ini nomor ordernya kita harus lebih spesifik, harus tuliskan di sini. Dan juga tanggal suratnya. Oke, nah itu hal pertama yang kita harus perhatikan. And then kita harus perhatikan ini, ya. Ini langsung harus kita koordinasikan dengan pihak gudang, ya. Oke, biar kita tahu barangnya ada semua atau tidak. Biasanya seperti itu, ya. Nah, baru setelah itu kita sudah tahu semuanya barangnya ada, complete, baru kita kirimkan suratnya, ya. Oke, dua hal itu penting yang harus konfirmasi ke bagian gudang, barangnya ada atau enggak, dan kita harus melihat penandaan-penandaan seperti ini, ya. Tanggal suratnya dan nomor ordernya, seperti itu. Okay, thank you. That's the end of our discussion for today. If you have any question related to this topic, I need you to open up the camera and ask directly. Yeah, silakan. Melinda and Adlan, thank you so much for helping me reading. Itu cara saya untuk kelas saya biar aktif. Jadi it's not only me to talk. I need your voice, ya. Apalagi ini kalau sesi akhir biasanya I need you to join me opening the camera. Biar terlihat bahwasanya aku dan kamu adalah manusia yang hidup. All right. Raihan, do you have any question? No. Ray?
No, sir.
Naufa Hafiz, do you have any?
No, sir.
Okay, I can see from your smile. You've understood all I explained just now. Thank you. Muhammad Rauf?
Yes, sir.
That's right. Thank you for responding. And the last person I'm asking, where is the girl excluding Melinda? Ada satu lagi kan? Ada satu lagi kan Melinda? Siapa namanya?
Ada Aulia.
She doesn't come.
Enggak tahu.
She doesn't come. Enggak tahu. Kamu kan dua sahabat come. Dari semenjak kelas tingkat 2 harusnya kan seia sekata. Kalau kamu masuk, coba undang dia masuk. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the end of our discussion for today. If you have any question, please deliver your question to Abrar, and Abrar will deliver a question to me. And the last time, I always say to my students, I love you, and I'll see you next week. Bye.
Bye.
Have a nice day. My nice pleasure. Evening.
Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon.
Thank you,
sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Unique.